Dr. King arrived in Memphis and they checked into the Lorraine Motel. A storm was forecasted for later that evening. There was a tornado warning, and a tornado touched down in Arkansas and it killed a few people. And then later that evening, a tornado touched down just north of Memphis and it killed a few more people. Now, Doc was not feeling well. He didn't think that anyone would show up for the rally at the Mason Temple Church of God in Christ. So he asked Dr. Abernathy to go to speak in his stead, and of course, Dr. Abernathy did. Surprisingly, news cameras and crews were there, and 2,000 people showed up in the storm. Many of them were sanitation workers. And when Dr. Abernathy and the others walked out onto the rostrum, the congregation erupted in applause, and then it suddenly died down once everyone realized that Dr. King was not with them. Dr. Abernathy knew that they were not applauding him. He went to a phone to call Dr. King. He had to strongly convince Doc to come, and over time, Doc eventually agreed to come. Dr. Abernathy was supposed to speak and Dr. King was to give remarks, but Dr. Abernathy introduced Doc for like 30 minutes. Well, needless to say, the congregation was ready for Dr. King. So Dr. King went to the podium. He was tired, frustrated. He had a temperature of 102 and he had no notes in his hand. And he preached his I've been to the mountaintop speech. Now, if you've never heard it, it is a magnificent message which began classic Dr. King eloquence. He talked about economic strategies. He thanked other preachers who were there for their contributions to the movement. But the most poignant part of his message occurred in the last 2 minutes when he referenced Numbers chapter 20, when God told Moses that he could see the promised land, but he just could not go to the promised land.
Well, I don't know what will happen now. We've got some difficult days ahead. But it really doesn't matter with me now, because I've been to the mountaintop. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place. But I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And He's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you. But I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. My eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
And if you listen closely, you will hear him going into the second stanza. He's trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He turned around, went back to his seat, and he collapsed in the arms of the individuals who were around him. He was greeting them from a seated position. Doc left it all on the field.